Greetings, travelers, and welcome to Traveler RPG Headquarters. You can find our Facebook group by searching our name, Traveler RPG Headquarters, on Facebook. I'm your host, Frank Sicardi, also known as Cyborg Prime, and today I'm happy to introduce Mr. Omer Joel. Welcome, Omer.
Hey, hello.
So, you're one of the publishers in the traveler world. You represent Stella Gamma Gaming, is that correct?
Stella Gamma Publishing.
Publishing, thank you. And, well, thank you for participating in our May Day Traveler Day event. It's a day we celebrate Traveler and all its offshoots for all the fun times it's given us. And since this is our first May Day event, I just want to thank you for being part of it once more. So tell us a little bit about yourself. Where are you from?
I am from Israel. I used to live in the States. I was born in the States, but I moved to Israel quite a long time ago. Right now, I'm doing almost all of my work through the internet, both local translation work, which is my day job, and all the Stella Gamma work. It's an international project. I will talk about it in a minute. Today with the internet, you could live in one end of the world and work with people all around the planet.
Yes, that's awesome. It's something that a lot of people never dreamed that they could do as a job, was, you know, to telecommute like that and work, or even, you know, play with people on the other side of the world. It's amazing. So so your day job is translation work. What did you do before you got into game design?
I used to work in translation since the turn of the century. Before that, I worked as a customer service representative, which is a far worse job. And translation is, again, it's my main job. I didn't study specifically. I have a master's degree in geography, but what I'm good at is writing and translating. So in my day job, I translate all kinds of legal and bank documents, but this gives me the ability to dedicate time to gaming as well.
And how did you first hear about gaming? Has gaming always been part of your life, or how did you kind of get into doing role-playing games?
Around, I think, the ninth grade, we got the old AD&D books, old AD&D second edition, which were in Hebrew, they translated it here in Israel, and we started playing. The first campaign lasted around 2 sessions, because people were young and not very well organized. But then I started DMing it to one of my friends, which lasted for a few years.
Hmm. And then how did that translate into science fiction gaming? How did you learn about Traveler or get into that genre of games?
This is kind of funny, because I found Shadowrun, again in translation, quite bad translation, but very nostalgic.
Great game.
And when I wanted to buy more Shadowrun books, it was in a time we didn't have almost any kind of gaming stores in Israel. So there was this guy who was importing products. Again, mind you, it's around the turn of the century. Most people couldn't order things online. So this guy sold me a few Shadowrun books out of the trunk of his car, as well as a Traveler book, which he said is a great find. It was the old reprint of books 0 to 9 of Classic Traveler.
Fantastic. And so what did you do with that? You just decided to GM and start a group, or how did that go?
I started building universes and ships with it. But later I started playing quite a lot online, because most people here want to play Dungeons & Dragons.
Right.
So if I want to play science fiction, I have to play by post mostly.
I see. I've never played by post. Is that a? It seems like it would take a long time for responses. I don't know if I could be patient for that.
Actually, there is a faster version of it through Discord.
Oh.
Where you have a channel, and again, you could post several times a day. Sometimes you could have an online session if you want, so Discord chat.
Oh, that's a good idea. That makes it much more. Makes it much more casual. So tell us a little bit about your business, Stella Gamma Publishing. Is that a business you started, or is that a partnership you came into?
I started this with Richard Hazelwood around 2016, when we decided we wanted to publish one of our shared universes. So I started writing this universe myself, and we wanted to publish it. This is what became The Stars Are Ours. And we started working on it. We published several things for White Star RPG, because it was interesting and very easy to write for. And then we started writing for Cepheus Engine. We wanted to write for Mongoose Traveler, but it was easier from a business standpoint to work with Cepheus Engine.
So what all games do you write expansions for? The Stars Are Ours, which, and that's something you came up, that's a product of Stella Gamma.
Yes.
And you write for, tell me about White Star.
White Star is an RPG, if you want, I could look up its publisher later, which is like early Dungeons & Dragons converted into Star Wars. And it's very, very easy. It's based on Swords & Wizardry White Box, which is one of the first retro clones. And it's very, very rules-light and very easy to work with because the rules are very simple.
Uh-huh.
And at the time, it still has a very interesting community, but I was in its community, so we published several things for it. And later, we published for Cepheus Engine, also for Stars Without Number.
Oh, yeah, Stars Without Number. I've seen that that too out there on the market. So when did you publish your first expansion, and what was it?
My first RPG book was not for Stella Gamma. It was for Speaker Publishing, called Outer Veil. It was in 2011. Which is another setting, it's a complete setting for Traveler. It was under the old Mongoose license,
uh-huh.
which is near future, quite lower tech setting. I might want to revisit this kind of thing, but it was very formative experience to write my first commercial product.
What was the hardest part about it? Do you remember?
It was several things. For once, I did almost everything for it myself, including art and deck plans, which I'm not very good at, but it was, at the time, it looked okay. And of course, it saved a lot of money because hiring a professional for this, you know, cost professional fees, which are quite high. But I did about 20 deck plans of ships, including large ones. I did the star maps. And again, it was organizing my thoughts. I think this project has flowed in several ways because it was my first and I'm not experienced yet with this. But right now, I learned from these mistakes.
What would be your advice to new publishers or people with ideas?
First and foremost, every single paragraph of your book has to have a plot hook in it. Anything which is not relevant directly to playing into the game itself, which means plot hooks and plot ideas, shouldn't be in your book. All kind of background, you know, in fantasy creation stories. If it's not going to play a part in your actual game, in an actual game, it shouldn't be there.
That's good.
On the other hand, you should put as much plot hooks as you want in it. Not only as you could put. Not only put a list of words that have, which was in Outer Veil. Several words were detailed, but a lot of it was, you know, general setting description and word data. So what we did in this Stars Are Ours to improve things, every word we included as a description, which is built in one or two or three plot hooks for direct use. It has to be useful.
Good advice. So I was looking through your product catalog and I noticed a book that kind of stood out there called Cauldrons and Casseroles. What's that about?
This is a cookbook. It's fantasy themed, but it's a cookbook designed for gamers, especially since you could eat with your hands next to the gaming table without needing cutlery or dishes. It's an excellent product. It's again provide you with over 80 recipes for all kinds of food. It includes several vegan options. Well, mostly it's not vegan, but there are several vegan options.
Uh-huh, I was going
if
to
If you
ask.
Want. It has measurements in both metric and imperial systems.
Nice.
So you could use it around the world. And again, it's rated for difficulty. Most of the stuff is quite easy to make. And we are now working on a print version, which I think if I could get it right, it will be even published through DriveThruRPG, which means a higher professional standard, but we're working on it.
All right, that's a great original idea, and I like it. I like snacks, and I like gaming, and I like gaming and food together. And to have a cookbook to tell me ways to do that, I think, is a fantastic and original idea. So you mentioned earlier that you work with a team at Stella Gamma that's all over the world. Would you like to talk about, introduce those other folks you work with? Tell us a little bit about them.
We're a team of five people. The first is Richard Hazelwood, who founded the company with me. And later we were joined by Josh Peters, who was an excellent editor. He also published several of his products for us. But I think as an editor, he does the right job by having no kind of respect, if you want to say. That is, he will say what he has to say. He will cut down your product and then it becomes the best product in the world. And we have Robert Weaver, who published one adventure through us and working on another adventure. He is also an expert in creating book indexes. And we have Hannah Saunders, who wrote Cauldrons and Casseroles, and he's also working on several adventure models for fantasy work, and is our in-house artist.
I love books with good indexes. It's very, very important to me when I look at a book that has a good index, because I want to be able to find what I'm looking for. So I appreciate that you include that.
Yes, this is one of the better features in This Stars Are Ours.
So what kinds of games do you like to play now, aside from RPGs? What do you have, a favorite board games, or do you have favorite card games?
I play video games, or more accurately, computer games.
Uh-huh.
Of all kinds, they are very inspirational, and several of them inspired These Stars Are Ours, or other of our products. I think it's a medium which is slowly replacing cinema and television as a medium to convey a story. Several of these games are excellent. And right now I'm playing a little bit less because I'm dedicating my free time to publishing, but still I'm into video games. I tried to get into miniature wargaming, but right now most people here want to play Games Workshop games, which are less to my taste, but I have my miniature collection.
Which video games inspired The Stars Are Ours, or most inspired?
First of all, XCOM, if mm-hmm. you remember the old series. I came up with ideas for These Stars Are Ours before the remake. Mass Effect, Star Control 2, if you recall it. If you speak about Outer Worlds, there is of course System Shock and System Shock 2, which are two classics.
Yes, great games.
Two horror classics.
Yeah.
And of course, a lot of other games which are an inspiration for my work. You had Stalker, which will inspire a game where I'm working on in the conceptual level. There are a lot of excellent games which are my other gaming experience.
So, in my opinion, it's important to recruit new players, you know, into this science fiction gaming world. How do you recruit new players? And are you always the GM, or do you get to play too sometimes?
I get to play. I'm right now in a fantasy game through Discord, where I'm a player. And I'm working on starting my own new Cepheus Engine game. It will take some time for me to get around to it, but it will be in Discord. And probably another fantasy game, because I think it's much easier to do all these kinds of things by play by post on Discord, considering the fact that people come from around the world. So this way you could circumvent the time differences.
Do you ever get to go out to conventions or local gaming stores, or promote your products that way?
Yes, I go to conventions from time to time. Most of my products are English, and local conventions usually sell Hebrew stuff. But I think I will translate one of my shorter products, which is Cepheus Faster Than Light. I think I'll translate it by myself to Hebrew, and then I could sell it even better at conventions.
Do you have any funny convention stories or anything interesting that happened out of the ordinary?
Not much in this case. Usually I come only to buy a lot of stuff and to sell some books, because some of the games and conventions could have their own problems. They have problem players sometimes. I was in a Shadowrun game about 20 years ago at a convention, which was a little bit simple and linear in this case, but it was quite a formative experience of learning how to play with people who are complete strangers, mm-hmm. not your friends. It was interesting to learn it.
I did my first convention this last year, and it was very interesting. I'd never been to a sci-fi convention before, and I really enjoyed myself. So, let's talk about your future plans, but before we do, let's welcome any new travelers who might be joining us. Greetings, travelers, and welcome back. This is Traveler RPG Headquarters. You can find our Facebook group by searching Traveler RPG Headquarters on Facebook. I'm your host, Frank Zuccardi, called Cyborg Prime Online, and today I'm talking with Mr. Omer Jewell of Stella Gamma Publishing. Welcome back, Omer.
Hello.
Hello. Let's talk about before we get into your future plans or talk a little bit about, more about Cepheus Light. Do you have a most memorable travel-related gaming moment, either as a player or GM, that kind of stands out in your brain?
It is mostly the things that most stand out for me are not in games, but in preparation for them, because this is what makes Traveller an excellent game beyond its own playing system. On mechanics, which are excellent. The first time I rolled up a subsector was a very interesting experience. You suddenly have your universe in your hands, which is procedurally generated, and it's very interesting. You start working for me. It was a very formative experience.
I had to, I felt the same way. I spent a lot of time going on vacations when I was young, and I took my traveler books along, and I spent all my time making subsectors and then thinking about stories about what goes on in that subsector. So I'm glad to find out other people did that too. What sci-fi authors or titles most influence or interest you?
I think it's a combination of several things. There is Kim Stanley Robinson with the Mars trilogy, which is excellent. I think excellent hard science fiction. It inspired Outer Veil, a few parts of it. There's Babylon 5, which is an underrated old sci-fi television series. Mass Effect on the computer, System Shock, Alien and Aliens, of
Of
course.
course.
And most of the media which is inspiring me to science fiction is visual media. It could be television or film or video games. Because some of them, they touch your sense of wonder in ways that some novels can do, but a lot of novels I read, they don't do it quite well enough.
It's sometimes easier to visualize things when you can see them rather than imagine them.
Yes.
Yeah. So let's talk about Cepheus Light. So, what are the main features of this product? What inspired you to write it?
So Cepheus Engine, and while it's an excellent game, I thought that for newer players it's a little bit less accessible because it's based on the old Mongoose SRD standard reference document, which is quite complicated. It's a lot of fiddly bits in it, which new players not always need it. They could use much faster and simpler rules. So I started simplifying it. At first, I tried to take the SRD itself and start modifying it, but I found that writing everything from the ground up based on it, which was easier. And then we added examples for all of our rules, which are, I think, the most favorite part of it with the audience.
That's good. It's nice to have examples to go by when you're a new player.
Exactly.
Yes. So what about any upcoming projects? Do you have any expansions for Cepheus Light coming up or any plans for new products coming out?
We are working on a few products. One of them is going to be UFO book. You could say it's for The Stars Are Ours, but it's going to be useful for any game you want. Classics, flying saucers, and classic UFO types and aliens with deck plans. We already have the deck plans ready. And stats for Cepheus Engine and Stars Without Number and White Star.
Sounds great. So,
And we are working also on Sword of Cepheus, which is a sword and sorcery version of Cepheus Engine. It's about two-thirds written, and of course after this it will go to several editing rounds, but it's going to be very, very cool. It has skill-based magic, all the rules you need to fight all kinds of legendary monsters. It's not Dungeons and Dragons, much more deadly, I think. And it's much of traveler type, of course. You could still play your mages and things, but your mage will have to take risk when casting spells, for example. It's also not going to give you in the core book a lot of what you could say Dungeons and Dragons fantasy. That is, it's not going to give you elves or dwarves. It's much more around the lines of Elric or Conan.
Gotcha. All right. Sounds great. So, if people are interested in these products, how do they contact you? Do you have a website, a Facebook page?
We have a Facebook page. We might have a web page later, but the Facebook page right now is a very good way to communicate with people.
All right. Well, it looks like our time is about up. I'm your host, Frank Sicardi, also known as Cyborg Prime, and I've been talking with Mr. Omer Joel of Stella Gamma Publishing. Omer, thank you so much for participating in our Mayday, Mayday, Traveler Day event. Give us your
You're
contact
welcome.
info one more time. How do we find your product line? DriveThruRPG?
You could find it, of course, on DriveThruRPG. You could search Stella Gamma Publishing on Facebook.
Well, that's it then. Thank you so much for being with me, and thank you to our listeners. And until next time, travelers, happy traveling.